Oh, yeah, he's back. The crack of the bat, the ping of the crossbar, and the roar of the crowd. We cover everything you want to talk about. It's the Rod Pedersen Show.
All right, technical gremlins taking us down on day one, but we're back live, the inaugural broadcast of the Rod Pedersen Show. Rod Pedersen, Darren Dupont, and thanks for those that have stuck with us through Facebook Live and online. The audio only at rodpedersen.com. It is the maiden voyage of the program. It is indeed, Darren, a new era of sports talk here in this province and on Facebook Live as well, which we're going to get into some of the details of how we got here. We're not going to do a real deep dive or long story. We're going to jump into the deep end of the sports talk here in moments. Everybody knows who I am and why we're here. But this particular program that we're launching today has been more a dream of yours than a dream of mine for quite some time. So before we get to our first guest, which is Gary Lawless of the Vegas Golden Knights, coming up in moments, maybe just your thoughts on why we're on the air today with this program.
Well, it's funny. I don't know if you would have thought we'd be here a year from now, or you know, even 5-6 months from you know earlier prior to today. But no, it's cool. It has. It's been a dream of mine ever since I think we started doing shows together live in the cage. We were doing training camp shows when I was up in Saskatoon still. That's when it started, right? And then, you know, we turned into last summer coming in and then moving to Regina. That's when it really started. And I knew that, hey, we needed to do this because there's so much more that can be done. There's such a, I mean, just look at the people who are watching now. Enough people to crash the feed. I mean, that's how much people want this, right? So it's an underserved market, and this gives people a chance to get served in a whole new way.
Well, we're going to talk about some fun things here in a little bit before we bring on Gary Lawless as to maybe who some of the well-wishers have been. But I just want to just talk about the last 6 months and how we got here. I mean, when I left the job as voice of the Rough Riders, I was leaving. I was going to another province, a major market, to have my own talk show. But a couple things tripped that up. One was my family didn't want to move. Two, in the interview process, they said that you're going to have to start all over building your name. And that immediately was a red flag to me. I don't want to do that. I've been on the air in this province 30 years. I don't want to start all over. And three, it just flashed to my mind that I don't want to leave these people, the people of Saskatchewan, which, based on the viewers of our news conference on Thursday, 87% of the viewers were from Saskatchewan. So I'm working, as I mentioned in the news conference on Thursday, full-time in recovery, mental health and addictions, with athletes in Saskatchewan, farmers and producers in Saskatchewan, and soldiers in Saskatchewan. And honestly, that's where I had planned on my life going. But as time went along, after leaving CKRM and that job, my phone started ringing. The SJHL called, would you come be involved with the league in a variety of roles? And I want to do that. And then the Saskatchewan Rush called and said, would you come and come up for a game and guest host one of our games and sit in with our staff? And that's something that I want to do that I haven't been able to do before. And this show itself is going to be a lot different than the Sports Cage for a variety of reasons, and people are just going to have to tune in and watch as to why that will be. But as you see here, Rod Pedersen Show, it's not the Sports Cage. So, you know, a lot of questions came up and have come up about, did you have to bite your lip before and all that? That's, sure I did. But I don't think people understand why. And we're going to get into that. But we're going to talk about things on this program every day from 10 a.m. to noon that we wouldn't even have the opportunity to talk about on that program. So that's kind of my opening preamble, I guess, that I didn't even plan to get into here on the warm-up. But I'm just excited to be part of this. And I want to thank you and Paul at IKS Media for the opportunity to do this.
No, it's really cool. You know, I got to wonder, the recovery stuff for you has been so big. Why so big? Because you would think that isn't the rider stuff and the, you know, the speaking tours and hanging out with Brock Lesnar and Henry Burris and those guys, isn't that more fun?
Sure. Well, I can still do that. I'm still doing that stuff. I was very busy in the spring doing those sporting events. But when in this life now, and since I've been working as a recovery coach in the last 2 years, I would say every couple of days, somebody's saying to me, you saved my life. And they're not joking because people save my life. I'm a recovering addict. I still battle mental health issues. I don't think that's news to anybody. So when people tell me that, I know that they mean it. And they're so indebted. They're like, take my watch, take my credit card, whatever. They're so indebted for you to do that. And it's like, no, it's fine. It's just helping people to find the right way. And what I love about that is that feeling is that you get. I immediately, when I started doing it really early on, realized all the coaches that I've dealt with through my whole sports career, I didn't understand them till now. Coaches are only good as their players, you know, and that heartwarming feeling when somebody, or a teacher, same thing, when somebody reaches the potential that, and you've helped them do that, it's a lot better feeling than being on the radio every day. It's just 30,000 people don't show up to see me do an intervention, okay? So I get it. It's not sexy. It's not exciting. The sports portion of it is. But one thing that I've realized is, why can I not do both of those things? So, and I'll give you a great example. Coming up on this program, I think Friday night they're going to debut it here on the Rod Pedersen Show, rodpedersen.com. The interview with Corey Sheets, where we're talking about the 2013 Grey Cup and him setting a record for rushing yards in a game, a Grey Cup game at 197. And then he just blurts out that, oh, in the last 5 years since I played regularly, I tried to kill myself and was institutionalized for 5 days with mental health issues, like out of the blue. And this is why I said it in the news conference on Thursday, why I think I'm needed more in that field is that people like me and like Corey Sheets, and I'm not going to list guys because that's their issue. It's not for me to say. But when coaches and bosses and, you know, commanding officers can't handle somebody, they put them in a room with me and I can sit down and three words will get them to completely open up and we're on the road to recovery. And that's just a better feeling for me. That's why I think I'm being used to do that. However, over the last 5-6 months, broadcast executives have said to me, you need to be on the air, right? You need to be on the air. So let's find a way for you to be on the air. And so whether that's yourself, Paul, you know, my other television show, I guess I have the ability to do that, but I've got a gift to do the other thing.
Why not do both, right? Why not?
That's what I'm doing. That's what I'm doing.
You're watching Rod Pedersen On Demand. For more of The Rod Pedersen Show, visit rodpedersen.com or follow Rod Pedersen on social media.